time had run out, as if history were no more than a tune on a player piano. But we did not know that then.
After the death of Coalhouse Walker Jr., younger brother drove south to Mexico, where he joined the great peasant revolutionary, Emiliano Zapata.
Signs of the coming world war were everywhere. The radical anarchist Emma Goldman was arrested again, of course. But this time, she would be deported as well.
Booker T. Washington's Tuskegee Institute became, in time, the capital of Black America. When he died, flags were flown half-mast. President and Mrs. Wilson attended the funeral.
Grandfather resided now in a cemetery. At last, peace and quiet.
The passionate and beautiful Evelyn Nesbit would lose her looks and fall into obscurity.
Harry Houdini was hanging upside down over Times Square when the Archduke Franz Ferdinand was assassinated in Sarajevo.
What of the Duke?
The young boy's words suddenly echoed in his mind. It would be the one true mystical experience of his life. It was too late. The world was already at war.
When the Lusitania was torpedoed by a German U-boat off the southwest coast of Ireland, 1,200 men, women, and children lost their lives. And among them, father.
Mother wore black for a year. At the end of this time, Tate proposed, and she accepted. She adored him.
We moved to California.
One afternoon, watching his children play, Tate had an idea for a movie. A bunch of children, white, black, Christian, Jew, rich, poor, all kinds. A gang, a crazy gang, getting into trouble, getting out of trouble, but together, despite their differences. He was sure it would be a wonderful movie. A dream of what this country could be! He would be first in line to see it.